गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ द नाइन्थ एंड लास्ट वीडियो ऑफ चैप्टर टू इकोनॉमिक्स. चैप्टर नेम इज़ सेक्टर्स ऑफ इंडियन इकोनॉमी एंड दिस वीडियो इज़ फॉर द स्टूडेंट ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 10. हेयर इन दिस वीडियो वी विल रीड अबाउट हाउ टू क्रिएट द एम्प्लॉयमेंट. अर्लियर वी हैव रेड इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो अबाउट द अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट एज वेल एज वी रेड that what government is doing for providing the job to the people, especially to the rural people. Here we will see some more ideas which will help us to understand that how to create more employment. So as you can see, how to create more employment. Diversification of agriculture. What does it mean? More than 60% our workers are employed in agriculture, but our farmers are producing only limited crops. There is need to diversify agriculture. Farmers should be encouraged to adopt PC culture, horticulture, animal rearing, etc., along with cultivation of crop. So this is the diversification of agriculture. As we read already in our geography that agriculture not means only to grow the crops, it also means rearing of animals. So people can get involved in the PC culture, horticulture, sericulture also. So this can just give the surplus to the farmer. As well as it will open the employment for those who are unemployed. The government can spend some money or banks can provide a loan to construct wells or other irrigation facilities to irrigate the land. A dam can be constructed or canals can be dug to irrigate many farms. This could lead to a lot of employment generation within the agricultural sectors. So itself reducing the problem of underemployment. We have read that underemployment is also same like disguised unemployment. So here you have to understand that diversification of agriculture means the job opportunity which government as well as individual person can open for other with the help of agricultural activities only. So that is diversification of agriculture, because most of the people in our country are just directly or indirectly engaged in agricultural activities. So for the dam construction, for the canal construction, for the well construction, many other job can be just opened by the government. By opening banks to provide easy loan for the farmers, to the farmers, so this can just open the job opportunities. Next is cheap credit. Most of the farmers depend on informal sources of credit, that is informal sources of loan. Government should encourage the commercial bank to provide loans to the farmers at cheaper rates. Okay, so what is this informal loans? There are two types of loans, formal loans and informal loans. Informal loans, it means suppose that one person has taken or borrowed money from his friend or his relative. So that is informal loan. But if he is visiting the bank and taking the loan by providing the proper certificate or the paper of the property, so that is the formal loan. So government should open more and more commercial bank to help the farmers, so that farmer can get the loan at cheaper rates. So in this way they can just engage, they can just utilize or invest such amount in other activities. Provision of basic facilities. Our rural areas lack basic facilities like roads, transportation, banking, market, etc. The government should invest some money in these sectors so that Indian village can be linked to other market. If you remember or recall the Palampur story, so that Palampur was developed village because it was well connected by the roads and transportation services was also active over there. So government should focus on the establishment or setup of transportation, banking and market, so that farmer can get easy transportation as well as banking facility and market they can get for selling their products. You can see here, this activity can provide productive employment to not just for farmers but also others, such as those in services like transport or trade. So the farmer who are just getting the loan from the bank, they are not only benefited. The person who are just engaging in the banking sector or the person who are just engaging in the transport services, they will also get the job. Next is promotion of local industries. Promote and locate industries, especially the cottage and small scale industries, in semi-rural areas where a large number of people may be employed. So many villages are having the potential, many villages has the potential to develop the cottage industry where they can do the production of different types of products, but they are not able to do so because they are not getting encouragement from the government side. They are not getting any type of fund also. They are not getting any type of infrastructure, or directly we can say that agglomeration of economy is not present. It means the basic facilities which requires to set up the factories, either the cottage or the small, that is not available. So once the factory or the mill or a small workshop will be opened, so that will just provide the job to other and open the employment. Fifth point is improvement in education and health. Most of the Indian villages lack education and health facilities. This is the genuine problem of most of the villages of India, not only India, in other countries also. A study conducted by the Planning Commission estimates that nearly 20 lakh jobs can be created in education sector alone. Okay. Similarly, we need many more doctors, nurses, health workers in rural areas. So simply you can see that if any PHC is there, primary health center is there in any rural areas or in block, so that is providing the job to 10 to 20 members, okay, or people living in the local areas as well as in other areas. So this way our education system and health sectors can open the job source for other people. And it is estimated, as we have read earlier only by the Planning Commission, that nearly 20 lakh jobs can be created in education sector alone. So imagine that when the health sector will also involve in that, so it will just give the boon to the country. Next is tourism or regional craft industry or new services like IT require proper planning and support from the government. A study by the Planning Commission says that if tourism as a sector is improved, every year we can give additional employment to more than 35 lakh people. So these are unexceptional data which we are just getting over here. So you can understand that 35 lakh people, if they will just get job every year, so that will surely improve the per capita income or increase the GDP of the country. So that we have to focus on. So this is the end of this video, students. I hope you understood. Thank you for watching.